You are beaten. It is useless to resist. Don't make me destroy you. Join me, and I will complete your training and bring order to the galaxy.
I'll never join you!
If you only knew the power of the dark side, I am your father.
Yo guys, it's time for Love Cup. So let's see what options I actually have going into this league. I've only got 9 Pokemon that's probably viable for this league. The rest I need to power up or try to build a team. Forget it, I'm a cheapskate. Let's go with Charmhole. So I'm going to try playing Charmhole in the 3100's Elo range. I know it's probably the most, you know, best team out there. It's probably the most skillful team out there as well. It's just absolutely amazing. Yeah, I'm going with probably the easiest team to use. And to be honest, the commentary on this will be like, okay, how do I explain the use of Charmhole? So what you need to do is basically just charm everything down and bait out the counters. So pretty much every team you're going to face is going to have some sort of counter for Charmhole, most likely 1 or 2. If they have 2, you've pretty much lost the game. The great thing about Crustle is that it really does well against all the fire types and also the bug types that are out there, especially like Scolipede. So there's not a lot of skill in this team, but it does get the job done. I used this team for about 5 sets and I went 16 out of 25, which isn't amazing, but it's very much like the Grasshole team or any other Charmhole team. It's pretty good at getting wins quickly, and it's one of those which isn't the best team out there, but it gets the job done quite efficiently. I don't really have much starters to invest in other Pokemon. I know Alolum, Lola, blah, blah, whatever that stupid fish thing is called, is fairly good. It's actually quite annoying. Electrode is really good as well, but it's one of those Pokemon that I don't really have built, and I really don't want to invest in the Stardust. So even though Charmhole is quite an annoying team or quite a degenerate team, a lot of things out there at the moment in this cup are quite the same as well. That stupid Alolum Lola fish thing is quite annoying to face against. You know, Chansey, Slowbro's. It's an annoying meta. It's an annoying game mode, to be honest. And it's either this or trying my best at the Master League. And I don't really have anything good for the Master League. XL Master League, I don't have anything built for. So this was my only bet. So luckily, I can skip out this Love Cup and also the Master League. But there's not a lot of options. It's pretty much a rock, paper, scissors meta or rock, paper, scissors league. So try to build a team that you can probably use and you should be alright with it. I mean, Charmhole, it gets the job done. It's not the best team out there, like I said before, but it hits hard and you don't have to worry about being too skillful with it because there's no way of really messing it up apart from just getting countered. As you can see, it's just, you know, complete beatdown, fast move beatdown. Crustle does really well as well at just beating down the Charizards. Satisfying. But yeah, the team is pretty straightforward and simple. If you do want to see some more videos in the Love Cup, let me know and I'll try and produce maybe another video before it ends. But yeah, it's a short league. You know, try and have some fun. I'm having a bit of fun with it as well. I'm just trying to get some starters actually, because when the leagues do come around, I do have some Pokemon that I want to invest in. And it is what it is. You know, there's not much I can say about this team. It just did the job. I go on a 4-0? Not 4-0, 4-0 in this set. I would have shown you all my sets, but I'm pretty sure you don't want to see 5 sets of Charmhole doing its thing. You know, it's a team that works. The queue times are fairly long in the 3000 ELO range. So it's just one of those things. You don't want to be spending too much time with these battles. And you just want to get them over and done with. And that's the great thing about Charmhole. It saves you time and it saves you Stardust. It's a cheap budget team that works. Yes, there's counters out there and there's going to be counters out there. But you know what? Use the team. Join the dark side. Use the team. It's still super strong. It's super effective. It works really well. And you know what? It's even working in the 3100 range, which I was surprised. I was going in these 5 games and expecting to get basically charm countered every single game. Thankfully, they only had 1 or 2 counters. You do see a lot of Medichams everywhere, so Charmhole itself can do quite well. I've seen a lot of Scrafties, so the meta is still defining itself, but it's just one of those rock, paper, scissors games. So, like I said, just use Charmhole if you have the viable Pokemon. It is obviously quite a Stardust investment if you want to, you know, invest in some other Pokemon, but you don't need to. I wouldn't really advise it for a one-week league. Especially because Stardust is really good for other Pokemon that you can use in the Great League and the Ultra League. I mean, yes, some Pokemon might be good to use in the Great League that you can power up now, but a lot of it is probably just an Electrode and maybe a Scolipede. I did power up a Vileplume, a Shadow Vileplume. It's alright, but there's a lot of Fire types out there. It does get countered quite heavily. And I have been using my... Wormadam Trash? It's fairly good, but again, the Fire types are out there, so I do need that stupid damn Alolan Lolafish to kind of make that team work, but yeah, I'm not going to really worry too much about this this league. It's just a little bit of a mess around by Niantic. They're having a bit of fun with it. They didn't even playtest the stupid thing, I'm pretty sure. They just went off and just said, you know what, it's Valentine's Day, let's put everything that's pink and red into this league, and I'm sure everyone will have fun. It's fun for a day or two, but it's like anything else, it's not the best. So yeah, try and have a little bit of fun with it, and you know what, let's just know your opponents and just beat them down with charm. That's probably the most fun you're going to have by actually picking a team that's going to annoy the shit out of them. But yeah, that's this team in general. Everybody knows what Charmhole already does by now. It's a team that works, it's a team that's cheap, it's a team that's, well, as you can see by this mirror match, it's very fun to use, so I highly recommend it. You know, I can come up with some more creative lines, but I just don't really want to invest in Stardust right now with these one-week league teams. But if you do want me to showcase a bit more, let me know and I'll see what I can do. But yeah, I'll let the last kind of game play on, and I honestly don't know what else to say. I've pretty much said what this team's good at, and you know, I didn't want to make the video too boring by showing this, you know, stupid Charmhole team that's just charming everything down. Crustle is quite interesting. It's quite a good Pokemon. You can invest in it. It does really well against the bug types. But yeah, the rest of the team is, it does what it does. But guys, thank you. If you enjoyed the video, please let me know. And also, I just wanted to kind of put my so-called opening scene idea out there. That was, I found that hilarious in my head. So obviously I don't have the skills to make it look extra high quality, but it is what it is. You know, budget skills here, budget team here, so that's everything. So hopefully guys, if you enjoyed, please let me know, and yeah, take care, thank you, all the best with the cup.